دبي تطلق تأشيرة للألعاب طويلة الأجل، وهل دايفرز 2 تصبح اللعبة الأكثر مبيعاً على الإطلاق على بلاي ستيشن؟ أهلاً بكم في حلقة جديدة من Game Changers، معي أنا حنان الكبت وبول دوليبي. Paul, we have big news in this episode and new announcements. When we talk about new announcements, we talk about Dubai, and it's all around the gaming industry.
Finally, Dubai in the gaming news. I love it. Can't wait to get into it.
Let's get started. كشف ولي عهد دبي حمدان المكتوم عن تأشيرة دبي للألعاب طويلة الأجل كجزء من برنامج دبي للألعاب لعام 2033. So according to that news, Dubai Crown Prince حمدان المكتوم unveils long-term Dubai Games visa as part of Dubai Games 2033 programs. It's a big announcement and finally from Dubai. What do you think about it?
Huge announcement. Very proud to say one that I'm involved with. I sit on Dubai's program for gaming, their working committee, so had a hand in helping this come to fruition. And obviously the idea here is facilitate talent coming to work in gaming in Dubai. Let's make it easy. Let's give them a visa that people can get so they can live here and work here. And Dubai is very good at that. Facilitating talent is one of the things they do best. I think what's interesting here is let's figure out what does the future of gaming look like in Dubai? Where will Dubai focus relative to the other regions, right? We've seen Saudi focus very much on esports. We've seen Abu Dhabi spend money and subsidize gaming studios. So where will Dubai play in all this?
If you want to talk numbers, they're talking about aiming to create 30,000 jobs and achieve $1 billion increase in GDP, and that's a huge number.
Big number.
And especially Dubai is promoting itself to be one of the top 10 cities in the gaming industry.
Well, I just think they will have to do two things. They will have to invest, because I don't think you can get this without investing. But I actually think that number could be actually quite conservative. I think we could end up seeing 100,000 jobs being created in gaming if Dubai invests and focuses on the right areas.
We saw this announcement from Dubai, but we have another announcement from Google. أعلنت جوجل في مؤتمرها السنوي للمطورين أنها تعمل على إضافة المزيد من التطبيقات والألعاب إلى السيارات التي تعمل بنظام أندرويد أوتو. So Google announced that it's working on adding more apps and games to cars running Android Auto. We saw many announcements in the annual conference, but what do you think about this?
Yeah, look, obviously the annual conference was very much focused on AI. AI was the big theme, but there was this announcement that sort of went under the radar, and I think it's a big one because we saw Tesla in the past really advertise gaming in your Tesla and that you could run really great games in your Tesla because now the cars are going to drive for
us. But now Angry Birds is coming to cars with Google built-in?
That's the beauty of it. Android Auto is everywhere. Almost every car these days runs Android Auto, and allowing any Android game to be played in your car, this could be huge. We could see the car be the next big console market, essentially.
So more entertainment options are never a bad thing, but now let's go to Sony. صرحت سوني أن Helldivers 2 هي اللعبة الأسرع مبيعاً على الإطلاق على بلاي ستيشن، حيث باعت أكثر من 12 مليون نسخة في أول 12 أسبوعاً من الإطلاق. So Sony say Helldivers 2 is the fastest selling game ever in PlayStation. They sell more than 12, we're talking about 12 million copies. So my question for you, why it's so special? Why we're talking about this game?
Look, this is a huge number, but talk about a roller coaster of news and emotion around this game for Sony. Because keep in mind, just recently there was a lot of controversy. And what they did, they saw that this game was going to be a success, Sony did, and they started mandating, or at least they tried to mandate, that people who wanted to play the game had to sign up for a PlayStation Network account. Now, this was obviously a big mistake. There was tons of backlash, gamers complained, and they reversed that decision. But it's obvious, I think, now why they tried to sneak that in. Because it sold so well, they want to own that customer relationship. They want to own that connection to the customer.
So you think this move was successful enough?
I think for sure they're not going to try it again, but Helldivers 2 will continue to sell, and it's a huge story. Best-selling PlayStation game of all time, that's amazing.
And now let's continue with GameSquare. أعلنت جيم سكوير عن إطلاق فيز ميديا من قبل فيز كلان بالإضافة إلى حصول الشركة الجديدة على 11 مليون دولار من الرئيس والمؤسس المشارك لمنصة درافت كينجز. So جيم سكوير announced the launch of فيز ميديا by فيز كلان. According to the recent poll, FaZe Clan or FaZe Media will focus on holding the value of FaZe brand. So what do you think about this?
I actually think this is a really smart move because pretty much everywhere except Saudi Arabia, esports is sort of a money-losing proposition. It's not financially sustainable pretty much anywhere in the world except in KSA today. And so as a consequence, esports teams, organizations, have to figure out better ways to monetize. And what FaZe is doing here is they're saying, our value is the brand. It's the FaZe name. So let's take that brand, create content, do merchandising, do whatever they want to sell with that FaZe brand on it, and create a company just around that. I think it's very smart. They're going to capitalize on the FaZe brand. And we'll see. It could be a roadmap for other big esports orgs to pivot to.
And now, Paul, let's continue our chat with our guest for today. وللحديث أكثر حول عالم ألعاب الفيديو تنضم إلينا أولغا فيلاتوفا وهي مؤسسة شريكة في AR Toys. Hello Olga, welcome to Game Changers. How are you?
I'm fine, thanks. And you?
I'm good, thank you. First of all, let me ask you, are gamers prime customers for toys and NFTs?
Frankly speaking, I think no, because the biggest audience of NFTs and toys are people who want to earn money, who like to speculate. And gamers are, I think, has another motivations.
Now let's talk about IP. IP is really big in the gaming world. We see big franchises, Grand Theft Auto, Call of Duty. How important is IP in the NFT world, in the toy world? Do we see that kind of importance?
Unfortunately, I haven't seen any big sale, NFT sale, with some game brand or game IP. I think this will change very soon because more and more people came to crypto, start to understand the benefits, and I think gamers also already in this group of people.
Now, you made an interesting comment about gamers not being sure that earning is something they actually want to do or speculating is something they want to do. And we've seen gamers reject NFTs in early versions. Mm-hmm. What do you think would make NFTs interesting for gamers or really exciting for gamers?
If it's going to be fun, if it's going to be fun, for sure it will be interesting for gamers and for more people. And also if it's going to be more simple, secure and transparent. And I think that's all. More fun, more people in crypto space.
Let's talk about studios. How can smaller studios leverage toys, NFTs in general for monetizing in general their market games?
Frankly speaking, it's very difficult. If you are a small studio and you don't have a community, it's quite difficult to earn something from NFT. But I have a small advice. If you can find some and you can inspire some influencer or artist to make a collaboration with you, this can work. And if you give some good utility, make some fun with your audience, I think you can succeed.
Well, let's talk about community because you mentioned community. How important is community building in the success of NFTs or toy collecting or games? Like, do you see community as a vital part of that?
For sure, community is a king there. So said that content is a king, but now community is a king. And only if the IP, the collection, the brand is interesting to a wide range of people, this is interesting for NFT and crypto world and people.
Thank you so much, Olga, for being with us in Game Changers. وبهذا كانت معنا أولغا فيلاتوفا وهي مؤسسة شريكة في AR Toys. عدنا إليكم مع فقرة سؤال جواب. لدينا سؤال على إكس يقول: هل على المطورين إعطاء الأولوية لإصلاح الأخطاء ومواطن الخلل قبل إصدار محتوى جديد لألعابهم؟ So it's a very controversial topic. You think we should give a priority to fix bugs and glitches before the release of new content of the game, for example? Because most of the people, or the majority, we can say, said yes. We have so many examples, Paul, and one of them is PUBG.
PUBG, absolutely, released very buggy, had lots of problems. In fact, they had a whole campaign at one point, if you remember, was called Fix PUBG. The developer actually started this campaign. So we've seen this a lot recently, and it's a result of games becoming more complex to make. So you have to, the cost is going up, the complexity is going up, you have to support more platforms. Right now the game needs to run on Xbox, PlayStation, PC, mobile. So there's more bugs in games. They're releasing buggier than ever. And as a consequence, you get a lot of players who are frustrated and are saying, hey, wait a second, don't release more content, fix the bugs first. 72% think people should fix the bugs first. But it's a balancing act, right? Because a lot of this is driven by financial decision making, not by what's best for the player.
But if you want to cut budget, of course you should like fix the bugs first before you release any game.
New content brings new players, which means it brings new dollars, right? So often studios will choose to put out new content instead of fixing bugs because it's more profitable for them to do so. I think only if gamers really rebel, only if gamers really stand up and say, we won't play a game, we won't buy a game, we won't pre-order a game if it's buggy, then the industry will change.
This is the end of our episode, Paul. Do you have any last comment you would like to say?
I will just say I'm personally so excited about Dubai's program for gaming and where that will go, because it's near and dear to my heart.
And it's very good to see so many actions happened in the gaming industry.
Absolutely.
مشاهدينا بهذا نكون قد وصلنا لنهاية حلقتنا من Game Changers. انتظرونا الأسبوع المقبل. إلى اللقاء.